Distant planets have always fascinated humans. From the early civilizations to the present day, our fascination with space has only increased over time, as technology has allowed us to discover more and more about the vastness of our universe. In the last 5 decades, humans have set foot on the moon and sent probes to other planets. Yet we've not even begun to scratch the surface when it comes to learning about the secrets of the universe. So in this video, we're going to look at the 10 biggest space missions that are planned to take off in the next decade. But before we start, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for more awesome videos like this. Now let's get into it. Number 1. The Parker Solar Probe. Although the Parker Solar Probe was launched in 2018 and its mission was to make observations of the outer corona of the Sun, the reason why we've included it in this list is because the Parker Probe is yet to complete its mission. The mission of the Parker Probe is not only to observe the outer corona, but also to make the closest approach to the Sun possible. The probe is all set to make the closest approach to the Sun by 2025, when it will come within 7 million kilometers from the center of the Sun, at a speed of almost 0.6% that of the speed of light. The Parker Probe was developed by the Johns Hopkins University with a budget of almost $1.5 billion, and it's the only probe to be named after a living person. On board the probe is a memory card that contains the names of over 1.1 million people mounted on a plaque. The Parker Solar Probe is the first spacecraft to fly into the low solar corona, where it's assessing the structure and dynamics of the Sun's coronal plasma and magnetic field. The energy flow that heats the solar corona and impels the solar wind, and the mechanisms that accelerate energetic particles. As the probe gets closer and closer to the Sun, its systems are getting exposed to extreme heat and radiation. For this reason, the spacecraft has a solar shield to protect it from extreme heat and radiation. The instruments on board the Parker Solar Probe are being used to trace how energy flows in the Sun and how solar winds get accelerated as they leave the Sun. The probe also has instruments to measure the structure and dynamics of the magnetic field of the Sun. The data gathered from this mission will prove helpful to understand the dynamic relationship between the Sun and the Earth. Solar space weather has become an interesting area of study for scientists recently. It's expected that the Parker Probe, along with other Sun-observing satellites, such as SOHO, will help scientists understand better how the Sun affects the Earth. The spacecraft made its 8th closest approach to the Sun on the 2nd of May 2021, and it sent a beacon back to Earth indicating that all of its instruments were still fully functional. Number 2. The JUICE Mission. JUICE, which stands for Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, is an interplanetary spacecraft mission that's currently under development by the European Space Agency. The JUICE mission will study the 3 moons of Jupiter: Ganymede, Callisto, and Europa. These 3 moons are expected to have large quantities of water, which may provide habitable conditions for life, thus making these 3 moons very interesting candidates for colonization. The water, however, is expected to be in ice form, thus ruling out little green aliens at least. JUICE is expected to be launched by June 2022 by an Ariane 5 rocket. After the launch, the JUICE Explorer will make multiple flybys of Earth. The first flyby of Earth will be in May 2023. Then it will use gravitational assist and boosters to head closer to the Sun towards Venus by 2023. It will then do another flyby of Earth in September 2024, followed by a flyby of Mars in February 2025, and one final flyby of Earth in November 2026 before committing to its trajectory for Jupiter. These flybys are like side missions, and they'll be used to observe Venus, Earth, and Mars closely before making the final approach to Jupiter's moons, which is the actual mission. Once the Explorer reaches Jupiter, it will orbit around the 3 moons, one by one, over many years, collecting data about the thickness of surface ice and other data markers that will help scientists understand the surface conditions of these moons better. The data gathered through the JUICE Explorer will be used for future robotic missions to further study the atmosphere and environment of these moons. Number 3. The Sphere X Mission. Sphere X stands for Spectrophotometer for the History of the Universe, Epoch of Reionization, and ICE's Explorer. Good thing that the geniuses behind this mission abbreviated it to Sphere X. Otherwise, every time they pronounce the name, the mission would be delayed by a week, at least. The Sphere X mission is expected to launch in June 2023. It's a 2-year mission with an estimated budget of around $300 million. Sphere X's mission is to survey the sky in optical as well as near-infrared light. Astronomers will use the mission to gather data on more than 300 million galaxies, as well as more than 100 million stars in our own Milky Way. The reason why missions like SpheREx or Hubble are sent to space to do the same thing that any large telescope or observatory can do on Earth is to get a clearer and unobstructed view of deep space objects. When you use a large observatory to observe faraway galaxies, the first thing light coming into the lens of the telescope encounters is the dense atmosphere of Earth, which can distort the light coming from space. This distortion can be avoided by sending observatories like SpheREx and Hubble telescopes into space, as they can picture deep space objects without any distortion. SpheREx is expected to study billions of galaxies and other deep space objects. The mission will also search for signs of water on other planets using its various sensors. SpheREx will perform a complete scan of the sky every 6 months, creating a comprehensive map of the sky in 96 different color bands. Number 4. The DART Mission. Remember the movie Armageddon starring Ben Affleck, Bruce Willis, and Liv Tyler? Remember how they set up a nuke on an asteroid heading straight for Earth? Well, this is pretty similar to that movie. The Double Asteroid Redirection Test, also known as DART, is expected to launch between the 24th of November 2021 and the 15th of February 2022. The DART mission was initially expected to be launched on the 22nd of July 2021, but was delayed to later this year. SpaceX has been commissioned to take the mission into space using the Falcon 9 rocket. The DART mission will head for the S-type asteroid system named 65803 Didymos. This binary asteroid system has two asteroids, namely Didymos A, which is around 700 meters in diameter, and Didymos B, which is around 153 meters in diameter. If the mission takes off during the launch window, it's expected to reach the asteroid system by September 2022, when it will start taking pictures of the asteroid system. The objective of the DART mission is to study the result of high-velocity impact on the motion of the asteroids. In other words, NASA is going to smash a spacecraft into an asteroid. If this isn't the coolest job in the world, then I don't know what is. The DART spacecraft will also carry a Lucia CubeSat, which will be jettisoned before the spacecraft rams into the asteroid to take images of the impact and transmit them back to Earth. The Earth-based observatories will study the impact on the motion of asteroids before and after the impact. The DART mission, therefore, can be considered a full-scale demonstration of redirecting the course and trajectory of any asteroid that may hit Earth in the future. Number 5. The Lucy Mission. Lucy is scheduled for launch in October this year and is set to be a flyby observational mission to study a belt of asteroids orbiting around Jupiter. Together, these asteroids are called Trojan asteroids, and for scientists, they're a good candidate to learn more about the surface composition, geology, and other properties of asteroids, as well as gain more understanding about natural satellites and ring formation. The Trojan asteroids are thought to be remnants of the material that formed the Sun and planets. It's assumed that once the planetary formation was complete, the leftover Trojan asteroids became attracted to Jupiter's gravity and now orbit the Sun with Jupiter. By observing these asteroids, the team behind Lucy aims to gain deeper understanding about the initial formation of the solar system, how giant planets accrete, and what was the source of the primordial organic matter in our solar system. The total budget for Lucy is capped at $450 million. Lucy's part of the Discovery mission, under which multiple low-budget spacecrafts are to be developed to study various aspects of the solar system. The spacecraft is about as big as a four-story building, but the bulk of its size is taken by huge solar panels. Lucy will, at first, encounter a small asteroid between Mars and Jupiter. It will study this asteroid and transmit the data back to Earth. Developers say that this will provide a good opportunity to test the systems of Lucy before it approaches the Trojan asteroids. Lucy's expected to reach the Trojan asteroid in 2027 and again in 2033. Number 6. Chandrayaan 3 Moon Explorer. The much-awaited Chandrayaan 3, which will be launched by the Indian Space Research Organization later this year, has an estimated budget of almost $81 million. The ISRO has previously sent two missions to the Moon. Chandrayaan 1 consisted of an orbiter and an impact probe. It was launched in 2008 and completed almost a year before losing contact. Chandrayaan 2 was less successful. It comprised of a lander and a rover, which unfortunately crashed in a hard landing. Chandrayaan 3 is the third attempt of the ISRO in 12 years to land on the moon. It will be a repeat of Chandrayaan 2 with a lander and a rover. Hopefully, successful landing this time will allow the ISRO to learn more about the moon and potentially compete with the other big nations leading mankind's space endeavors. Number 7. NASA's Dragonfly to Titan Voyage. Apart from the moons of Jupiter, Titan is another contender in our solar system that can harbor life, which is why scientists are so interested in studying the atmosphere and conditions of Titan. NASA is all set to send a drone named Dragonfly to Titan in 2027. It will take Dragonfly mission almost 7 years to reach Saturn's icy moon, Titan. Since the atmosphere of Titan is almost 4 times as dense as the atmosphere of Earth, the Dragonfly will be able to fly and carry the various equipment and instrument across Titan over a 3-year period. If successful, scientists could gather some much-needed data on whether or not Titan could be a viable moon for humans to inhabit. Number 8. The SpaceX Mars Colonization Mission. When it comes to space travel, SpaceX is the name that comes to mind first and foremost, and rightly so, because SpaceX has single-handedly changed the fate of space exploration with their innovative design and development in recent years. Currently, SpaceX is focused on their mission to Mars, which is expected to launch in 2024, just 3 years from now. Landing on Mars and creating a self-sustaining civilization is one of the main objectives of SpaceX as a company. So this mission is basically the lifeblood of SpaceX. Over time, SpaceX has developed reusable rocket boosters that allowed the company to take center stage. Reusable boosters are a key part of the Mars mission because SpaceX expects to land their spaceship through the boosters. SpaceX then developed the Falcon Heavy, which is said to be the most powerful rocket since Saturn V. Mars is 322.2 million kilometers away from Earth, and to get there, you need a big rocket with enough fuel. Once Falcon Heavy was successfully tested, SpaceX then focused on developing the Starship, which is going to carry the materials and eventually humans to Mars as well. The recent successful test of the Starship has breathed new life into the Mars mission, as SpaceX has everything ready for the unmanned mission to Mars in 2024. Once launched, the Starship will get into orbit around Earth, where it will be refueled for the rest of the journey. Once it lands on Mars, robots will assemble plants to extract minerals, which will be used to produce oxygen and propellants for the Starship, which will then be used to refuel and come return back to Earth. SpaceX intends to carry out multiple robotic missions, at first to transport the materials required to set up a colony, eventually leading to manned missions later in the decade. The Mars mission is surely one to look out for, and we hope that it won't get delayed. Number 9. The Artemis Outpost Mission. The Artemis mission marks the return of humans to the moon. NASA aims to send humans back to the moon by 2024, but this time we're going there to stay. At least that's what the plan is anyway. The Artemis mission is a multi-layered mission. The aim is not to simply go back to the moon, but to develop an outpost on the moon for the long run. The Artemis mission also has a component that includes using the moon for mining minerals, and many countries are signatories to the Artemis Accord that sees the moon as a mining base. So a small base will be set up on the moon for experiments and mining. There will be vehicles that will explore the surface of the moon, and there are also plans to create an orbiter around the moon. In the long run, the moon base is expected to help humans go deeper into space. Think of it like this. If you're going to Saturn, first you take your flight from Earth to the moon, where you refuel. Then you go to Mars for your next refuel, and then you enter cryosleep for the long journey to Saturn. This is at least how Elon Musk thinks space travel will develop. NASA has already chosen SpaceX to build a lunar lander. The Artemis mission, like many other missions of NASA, is being developed with the collaboration of multiple space agencies and companies, so it will symbolize the collective efforts of humanity to become a multi-planetary civilization. The Artemis mission will consist of multiple launches over a decade, starting with lunar landings, leading to a fully developed moon base. It won't be wrong to say that this has to be the most awaited missions of this decade. Number 10. The James Webb Telescope. The James Webb Telescope is set to replace the Hubble Telescope. This is how big this mission is set to be, and is also perhaps why it's taking so long, as NASA doesn't want anything to compromise the mission. The James Webb Telescope is an orbiting, infrared observatory that will replace Hubble with better and more advanced features, such as longer wavelength coverage and greatly improved sensitivity. The longer wavelength coverage will enable the James Webb Telescope to look deeper into space than ever before. The James Webb Telescope, once functional, is set to discover previously unseen galaxies and look at regions where new stars are being born. Its ability to look deeper into space also means that the telescope will be able to look further back into time, allowing scientists to understand how the universe has developed. The James Webb Telescope is being developed with the cooperation of multiple agencies, including NASA, European Space Agency, and Canadian Space Agency. The James Webb Telescope will be put into orbit between the Sun and the Earth. It will have a massive shield that will protect it from the light and heat of the sun, and will have gold-plated solar panels that will provide it with the necessary power to run its systems. Its main mirror is a 6.5-meter diameter gold-coated beryllium reflector with a collective area of 25.4 square meters. The design team faced a huge challenge in building this mirror. At this size, the mirror would have been too big and fragile to fit inside any launch vehicle. Developers did, however, find a way around this problem by designing a mirror that's composed of 18 hexagonal segments, which are all folded together. The mirror panels will unfold and assemble once the telescope is put into orbit. The reason why it's the most awaited mission is because development of the James Webb Telescope began in 1997 and was initially expected to be launched in 2007 with an initial budget of almost $500 million. Multiple project delays due to constant redesigns and budget constraints kept pushing the launch date. In 2016, the telescope was given the final green light and NASA started the testing phase. Unfortunately, the sun shield of the telescope ripped, causing the launch to be delayed further. In 2020, the final testing and launch were delayed due to COVID-19. And now, finally, the much-awaited James Webb Telescope is expected to be launched in October 2021. Fingers crossed. And there you have it. What do you think about these space missions? Was there any that I missed? Let us know in the comments section down below. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.